Hi, my name is Ola Rignell. I'm the Chairman and Managing Director of Saab India Technologies. So we are promoting the Saab products into India and have been on the Indian market for almost 40 years now.
Thank you so much, sir, for your time at the Dubai Asia 2021. So why is Gripen E the best choice for Indian Air Force to be manufactured under the SP model?
Well, in general, the Gripen is, you know, the most modern aircraft available today for India. And the setup that we have offered India is a package with a full transfer of technology, but also transfer of capabilities. So we are not only giving the Air Force a very potent aircraft, we are also giving the Indian aeronautical industry a good package of know-how and knowledge that they can benefit from in the future. Yes, that's a very good question. We have partnered up with Bell in India, and we are part of the close-in weapon system. And right now there is a competition or a tender out to give the Indian Air Force a very modern system for close air defense. So our G1X is part of the Bell offer to the Indian Air Force.
So what is the state of your JV with the Adani Group?
Right now, we have said that we are looking into how the fighter program develops. So right now, we are exploring the different opportunities, and we will see what comes out of it. We are expecting the AON and the EOI to come out hopefully early next year, and when it does, we will also look into how to partner with Indian companies.
And other than Adani, do you have any more collaborations with Indian companies?
Today we have several collaborations with different Indian companies, both on a tier 1 and tier 2 and tier 3 level. So for example, for the T7, Saab has put work onto an Indian company called Sasmos. We have other Indian companies who are a sub-supplier to us for Boeing and Airbus. We are also working with Tech Mahindra. We have the Saab India Technology Center in Hyderabad, where we actually develop software and hardware for the export markets. We are actually exporting products out of India without having an offset obligation, which I think is quite unique.
Great. So about the Make in India now.
Yes.
How is Saab collaborating to develop this kind of defense and aerospace ecosystem in India with the Make in India program?
Yes. So within the multi-role fighter aircraft program, we are offering a full transfer of technology. The Make in India regulation that now allows 74% FDI is, from our perspective, a very good approach. This will give Saab, as well as other companies, a possibility to really transfer the latest technology into India, which will also cater for the Make in India approach from the Indian government. So you will have the latest know-how that will support you both for your indigenous production, but as well for export production.
So do you feel this transfer of technology, it's a stumbling block, or you feel it's more of a pushing thing for Saab?
If I use a comparison, in Brazil, who bought 36 Gripen fighters from Saab, we have transferred know-how to about 300 people so far, who have been to Sweden. They have been trained and educated on how we develop fighter aircraft. They have now brought that knowledge back to Brazil. And together we have built up a design and development center. We have built up a flight test center. And we are doing this jointly between Saab and Brazilian industry. We are offering the same and actually more than that to Indian industry, where we promise to transfer all the capabilities that would support the MRFA program. We are also doing similar approaches for other products in India. And we are looking into how to establish ourselves more fixed into the Indian market for the future.
So what is the response from India for your offer of a Skelder VTOL UAV?
Well, there have been a large interest from India for Skeldar, both from Army, Navy and Air Force. And right now there is an RFI out for a UAV vehicle that should be capable of flying over desert and plains as well as mountains. And we are, of course, more than happy to propose Skeldar for that tender. Now the Skeldar is now in operation both with navies and armies worldwide. And I think it would be a perfect match for the Indian Army as well as for the Indian Navy and Air Force.
Thank you so much, Ola. Thanks for your time. And I hope the rest two days should be great for you and Saab.
Thank you so much, and have a great day.